My name is Kerry Farrell IV. I'm the president of the theater club and your MC for tonight. And I'm super excited to show you this first production of our newly formed theater club. We have information in our program about our club and about our members. If you are interested in theater in any way, whether it's acting or if it's other disciplines as well, if you like building sets or you like to be backstage and help with things or help in the tech booth, if you're interested in theater at all, we would love to meet you, right? We're the theater club, so I encourage you to meet us after the show or check out our Jackson page. There's a link there, there's a QR code. We covered all the bases. Are you excited to see our show? I'm very excited to show it to you. We have a lot of different acts tonight. It's a cabaret style show, variety show, lots going on. We got scenes. A lot of them, they're unrelated to each other. They're little scripted scenelets that we've put on for you. You'll see those a little later. We're also doing some improv. We have the renowned improv team, Good AF, here. They're, yeah, woo! We got an amazing performance from them later in the show. And also we have a guest, Showtime with Steve Valdez, which is amazing. I'm excited for you to see all of this. It's coming up soon. Of course, you can follow all this in your program. But first, I want to wet your whistle with a little bit of improv. Okay, I said Good AF is later in the show, but in the meantime, what I want to do is do a little improv with some of the members of our cast that they're not used to doing improv, but I am. Okay, so I've been doing improv for well over a decade. So we're gonna do a little experiment here. We're gonna see if I do improv with them one-on-one, if it makes amazing scenes, which I suspect it will. Okay, so just keep in mind that they're being brave here, they're taking a risk, so please, whenever you see a scene end and someone's leaving the stage, give them a nice warm hand. Let's practice that, everyone. Let's give it a hand. Oh my gosh, just did an amazing set. And that's how that'll go. All right, thank you so much. So, without any further ado, our first set of the night is a little bit of improv.
Okay, I see how it is.
What?
You didn't have to come all bravado at me, bro.
Well, you didn't have to either.
Okay, look, you just make me feel insecure.
Well, I mean, sometimes you make me feel insecure. How about that?
Wow.
Yeah.
All this time, you and me have been at each other's throats. Turns out we're just a couple of insecure bros.
Maybe that's what it is.
Maybe. Maybe we just need to hug it out, man.
Maybe.
You want to, like, okay. Maybe we have a lot in common. I mean, we've been fighting all this time. Like, do you like fishing?
I love fishing.
You like Pokemon?
Yeah. I mean, you had me fish.
Oh, well, we focus on the fishing.
You like honey?
Gosh. Maybe this isn't gonna work out, man.
Maybe not.
Done, you know, in the blowout.
Your hair looks really good today, actually.
You are so smart. Jump into the pool.
Oh, okay. Why? It's pretty cold outside. You really want to do that?
Well, you said to go first.
But why do you want to jump in the pool? I thought you were going to help me with volleyball.
Sorry. You're not so embarrassed.
Yeah, I don't know what kind of date you're trying to go for, but it's not that.
Just swimming. This is not weird to go swimming for a date, right?
I guess it is. Late at night.
At 12 o'clock at night?
Yeah, we don't
want
to do stuff at
12
o'clock at night.
Clearly, you don't want to go swimming at 12 o'clock at night.
That's weird.
Why is it weirder than volleyball? They're both physical activities.
You don't have to get up there with me. Calm it down, though.
I'm sorry, I just put a lot of thought into this date. I just feel like you're disrespecting it without even giving it a chance.
I'm not disrespecting it. You just told me that we're playing volleyball with your friend and you come up here at the pool.
I wanted to be surprised.
You think I want to get wet right now? It's so chilly outside. What are you trying to do out here? You're just like the other guys.
Good afternoon there, neighbor. To you as well. Good to see you.
Hey, tell me what you're coming to the garage sales this weekend.
Oh, your garage sales this weekend. Wow, you always have some dandy stuff that you
have. Yep.
I remember last time I came to your garage sale, I got that ironing board. Good as new. I still use it. Really good.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. What, you got any new sort of knickknacks or cool stuff at your garage sale?
Yes. Well, so we have this old, beautiful looking key set that I don't want to use anymore.
Key set. Where did I use this key set? Maybe I can start like a tea club. Or like a book club. When we drink tea at it. Do you want to join a book club? I just started.
Well,
okay. Well, thank you so much. I'll be at your garage sale later. I'm going to buy that tea set. And we'll have a book club.
Awesome.
Okay. All right. Thank you, everyone. Let's give another hand to all of our special guests. Hopefully, we got your whistle. Moving forward, we've got all kinds of great acts. I alluded to some of them earlier, but I'm very excited about this special guest. Next up is Showtime with Steve Valdez.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Our next performer is a very proud Jaguar. He graduates next month with a master's degree in business administration. He's also the boy that would never clean his room. Please welcome my son.
My name is Kerry Fair IV. I'm the president of the theater club and your MC for tonight. And I'm super excited to show you this first production of our newly formed theater club. We have information in our program about our club and about our members. If you are interested in theater in any way, whether it's acting or if it's other disciplines as well, if you like building sets or you like to be backstage and help move things or help in the tech booth, if you're interested in theater at all, we would love to meet you, right? We're the theater club, so
I encourage you to meet us after the show or check out our Jackson page. There's a link there. There's a QR code. We covered all the bases. Are you excited to see our show? I'm very excited to show it to you. We have a lot of different acts tonight. It's a cabaret style show, variety show, lots going on. We got scenes. A lot of them, they're unrelated to each other. They're little scripted scenelets that we've put on for you. You'll see those a little later. We're also doing some improv. We have the renowned improv team, Good AF, here. We got an amazing performance from them later in the show. And also we have a guest, Showtime with Steve Valdez, which is amazing. I'm excited for you to see all of this. It's coming up soon. Of course, you can follow all this in your program. But first, I want to wet your whistle with a little bit of improv. Okay, I said Good AF is later in the show, but in the meantime, what I want to do is do a little improv with some of the members of our cast that they're not used to doing improv, but I am. Okay, so I've been doing improv for well over a decade, so we're gonna do a little experiment here. We're gonna see if I do improv with them one-on-one, if it makes amazing scenes, which I suspect it will. Okay, so just keep in mind that they're being brave here, they're taking a risk, so please, whenever you see a scene end and someone's leaving the stage, give them a nice warm hand. Let's practice that, everyone. Let's give a hand. Just did an amazing set, and that's how that'll go. All right, thank you so much. So, without any further ado, our first set of the night is a little bit of improv.
Okay, I see how it is.
What?
I didn't have to come all bravado at the pro.
Well, you didn't have to either.
Okay, look, you just make me feel insecure.
Well, I mean, sometimes you make me feel insecure. How about that?
Wow.
Yeah.
All this time, you and me have been at each other's throats. Turns out we're just a couple of insecure bros.
Maybe that's what it is.
Maybe. Maybe we just need to hug it out, man.
Maybe.
You want to, like, okay. Maybe we have a lot in common. I mean, we've been fighting all this time. Like, do you like fishing?
I love fishing.
You like Pokemon?
Yeah. I mean, you have any fish.
Oh, we focus on the fishing. Yeah, right, right, right.
You like money?
Gosh. Maybe this isn't gonna work out, man.
Maybe not.
It's not like I'm an astronomer or anything. Are you an astronomer?
Yes.
Oh!
Oh.
Sorry, I'm not sure. Well, there's a lot in that general direction. What's that stuff called?
Look, I'm gonna give specifics. Just know where to start.
You are so smart. Jump into the pool.
Oh, okay. Wow, yeah. It's pretty cold outside. You really want
to
do that?
Well, you said to go first.
But why do you want to jump in the pool? I thought you were going to help me with a volleyball.
Oh, okay. Sorry. You're not so embarrassed.
Yeah, I don't know what kind of date you're trying to go for, but it's not that.
Just swimming. This is not weird to go swimming for a date, right?
Okay.
At 12 o'clock at night?
Yeah,
who doesn't want to do
stuff at 12 o'clock at night?
Clearly, you don't want to go swimming at 12 o'clock at night.
That's weird.
Why is it weirder than volleyball? They're both physical activities.
You don't have to get up there with me. Calm it down.
I'm sorry, I just put a lot of thought into this date, and I just feel like you're disrespecting it without even giving it a chance.
I
wanted to be surprised.
You think I want to get wet right now? It's so chilly outside. What are you trying to do out here? You're just like the other guys.
Maybe I could start like a tea club, or like a book club, when we drink tea at it. Do you want to join a book club? I just started it.
Well,
okay. Well, thank you so much. I'll be at your garage sale later. I'm going to buy that tea set, and we'll have a book club.
Awesome.
We've got all kinds of great acts. I alluded to some of them earlier, but I'm very excited about this special guest. Next up is Showtime with Steve Valdez.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Our next performer is a very proud Jaguar. He graduates next month with a master's degree in business administration. He's also the boy that would never clean his room. Please welcome my son, Evan Steven.
Good evening, everybody. So nice to be here. I'm Steve Valdez. We got some music for you. It's a tradition of the cabaret. We're going to start off this first song with the George Strait song. You guys are always welcome to sing with me if you know the lyrics, and we're going to have an interactive sing-along towards the second half. And also, Elvis Presley is going to make an appearance, so make sure you stick around after the intermission. This first song is by George Strait, and it is called The Fireman. You, the fireman.
Yeah, they call me the fireman. That's my name. Making my rounds all over town, putting out old flames. Well, everybody likes to have what I got, cause I can cool them down when they're cold. That's my name. Last night they had a bad one, a mile or two down the road, by me flat. Everybody walked off and let the poor woman out of control. Well, I was out there about an hour or so with the bills about to mount. She was ready to go on the fireman. That's my name. They call me the fireman. That's my name.
I got a fire engine red, T-Bird automobile. In a minute in that sack, we dress up to get. I work 24 on and 24 off. When they get too hot, they just give me a call. I'm the fireman. That's my name. They call me the fireman. That's my name. Making my rounds all over town, putting out old flames. Well, look, everybody like to have what I got, cause I can cool them down, but they're cold and hot. I'm the fireman, that's my name. They call me the fireman, that's my name. One more time, yee-haw!
That's right, we're in Texas, y'all, you know. Texas is all about country music, but you know what? A little bit to the south, we got this country called Mexico. And in Mexico, I started going about 25 years ago, and I didn't know how to speak Spanish at first. And within a year, I was actually doing really, really well. So I'd like to share some words with you that I've learned just recently. One of the words is regadera. Can you say it? And you guys know that that means, let me hear you.
Hose.
Hose? It means shower. Hose. What is a hose? Manguera. Manguera is a hose. Woo, you have me going, woo. Well, I also learned a couple of other words. One of them is secuestra, and that means kidnap. And then another one I learned was secuestra express, and that means when they kidnap you and they take you to the ATM and they take out whatever they can and then they let you go. So it's always nice to learn these words. Isn't that nice that we can learn things together? And so, ladies and gentlemen, we got a really special guest for you tonight. I brought with me a very special person. She's the one that did the introduction. She's a graduate of Black Stick High School, mother of four, grandmother of 10, great-grandmother of 3. Please help me welcome the brightest star in my universe, my mom, Mary Yavial Valdez. She goes by MVV for short. Please come out here, Mom. She's going to join me on this song. There she is. Watch her sparkle. We're going to sing this song, and it is called Beautiful Love. And it's a song about, it could be a love for a child, it could be a love for the love of your life. And it is called Hermoso Cariño. And she's going to sing second to me. Then after that, my mom's going to sing one on her own. She's 79 years beautiful. Isn't that an amazing?
Hello, hello. I'll be 80 in a few days.
Ándale, nombre. ¿Tuvo la música un poquito? Por favor, turn it up a little.
Hermoso cariño.
Se acabó. ¿Alguien no apaga la luz? ¿Qué pasó?
A working rehearsal.
Otra vez.
Nothing like the second time. Que soy un grito. That's more like it. Jaguar style.
Don't hit pause anymore.
Hermoso cariño, hermoso cariño, que Dios te ha mandado a ser destinado no más para mí. Precioso regalo, precioso regalo, del cielo ha llegado y que al colmado de dicha de amor. Hermoso cariño, hermoso cariño, ya estoy como un niño.
So grandma says to the granddaughters, get up, we're going to clean the house. And one of the granddaughters says, Grandma, I want to tell you something. I think you need to get busy. Grandma, let me tell you something. Well, what? I bet I can make you howl like a wolf. What? I can make you howl like a wolf, Grandma. How? How long has it been since you've been on a date with a man?
This is a song by Miss Etta James that my mom always gets asked to sing, and it is called At Last. Please enjoy. This is all about my mom, guys. And I've been like a song
fond agree that I could speak to a demon
scenes. I alluded to this early before we started. So all these scenes are disconnected. They're pulled from different material, from different plays or shows, all kinds of different places. So when you see the lights go down, that's the end of one scene, and the next thing is going to be totally different. And when you see the lights come down in between scenes, that's also a great time to show some gratitude. You can give some applause. Let's practice that again. Okay, guys. Excellent. All right, I think y'all are ready. So, without any further ado, the first of our scenes.
Really?
Yeah. Let's get to the bottom of my show.
man broke into my apartment and tried to kill me. He dented the wall where he bashed my head into it. If that guy in the mask hadn't have been there...
Oh, my cousin does drywall. I'll call him first in the morning.
It's not the apartment, Foggy.
I know, but...
It's just... I don't see it the same anymore. Like, all I see are dark corners. I look around this room, and all I see are threats.
This room? These guys are harmless. Look, that's Tom Belkin. He runs the Thanksgiving food drive every year. That's Rob Donahue. His wife, Mira, she works at the drive-thru down the street from our office. That's Clint Peterson. He made me a criminal. But he's driving around. And this oath to give these kids to St. Agnes. This oath. You don't want to go home? You don't want to go home. You can stay here all night and drink. Yes! Friends, Michigan. Why should I get caught, Blue? Look, Blue, do me a favor. Just move a few decimal points around. It's only $2,000. You can do it, Blue. You're an accountant. Count is in the title.
That's cheating.
Cheating? It's not cheating. It's charity. Blue, look at me. All right? Most men, they sail through life in luxury. But Bialystok has struck a reef. I'm sinking my world that demands success when all I have to offer is failure.
Oh dear, oh dear.
Help, Blue. Help.
Is any
entry
not
sure
that
clock? Yes, right. You'll figure it out. Thank you. I'm gonna take a nap. Wake me if there's a fire.
Now let's see. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. But under the right circumstances, a booster of new hormone for the problem could have been a hit. Yes. Yes. It's quite possible. If we were certain that it would block, a man can make a fortune.
Yes.
Yes, would.
What you were saying. Keep talking.
We're saying
that under the right circumstances, a producer could make more money with a flop than he could with a hit.
Yes.
You keep saying that, but you don't say how. How could a producer make more money with a flop than he could with a hit?
Get it?
you bloody brilliant person?
Oh, no, I meant Bilski. We just assumed the accounting theory.
Blue, worlds are turned on such theories!
Yeah, I got my list done. I would like to go first.
Jack, please. Can I talk to him before you send a judgment
of anything? That's how he is. He has absolutely no patience.
I have plenty of patience. I mean, I'm married to you, aren't I?
Great. Your homework was sent last week. Express. Don't attack.
Sorry, but this homework assignment has given me a lot of food for thought.
Ha! I'm not actually starving over here, you know?
Okay.
Thank you.
just a hunk of burning good. I'm just a hunk of burning good. Just a hunk of burning good. I'm just a hunk of burning good. I'm just a hunk of burning good.
Burning love. Original Justin Bieber. Oh, man. So now you have lyrics to a song, and now you're going to help me with this one. You're going to notice that everybody, there's a part where it says, everybody says, and that's where I need your help. But I also need your help on the whole song. You guys can sing it with me. If we get the house lights up, that'd be great. We're going to have some fun. This is a song about margaritas. And these particular margaritas don't have alcohol, right? Right. And so, if you'll sing it with me, it's a fun song. Kids, if you don't know this song, you will. Ah, yeah. Hello, Sponge Cake. What happened? All those tourists. We starting again? Otra vez. All right. Give me a chance to come down. And if I fall, you can laugh. House lights. Living on a sponge cake. Watching the sun bake. You take pictures of me too. All those tourists covered with oil. Here he comes. Strumming my sixth string. How you doing, baby? All my front porch swing. She's with me. Now that trim, they're getting the boy. We're just playing. Come on, sing. Wasting it away again like I really do. You guys are great. Get around and drink with me. Searching for my lost shaker of salt. One drink for everybody. Don't know the reason. Came here all season. Nothing to show but this brand new tattoo.
Salt.
Salt.
Salt. Salt. Salt. Salt. Salt. Salt. Salt. Salt.
you for your patience. Now I must warn you, the third song has swear words in it. It is a modern, kind of modern, but it's a killer song. Now I am not gonna swear, but you can. This is a song by Radiohead called Creep. Oh, of course you do. Can you crank that up a little bit more? If you don't know this song, you're about to get an education, right, kids? What's up, Benzo? All my friends are looking at me like, what? And look at you in the eye. I just like an angel. Should I go for it on the song? Your skin makes me cry, because there's a heart. It flows like a feather. And here you guys know this. It's not about me. Beautiful world. I wish I was special. You guys are on. But I would dream. I would dream. Down with the victory.
All right, let's bring those house lights out. Ladies and gentlemen, for the rest of the show, you're going to see some improv from my own homegrown cast here. Our special guest team, we have Good AF! So, ladies and gentlemen, you hear me use this word, improv. I want to expand on what I mean here. So, we're a series of actors that are going to be performing scenes and monologues for you, but none of this has been prepared. We don't have any structure. We have not planned anything ahead of time. Everything you're seeing right now is being performed for the first time and the last time. You're seeing a unique performance that will never exist ever again. And everyone goes, ooh. Yeah, so we'll get prepared for that. I'll hand off my mic.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, give one final hand for Good AF.
You're here today. Look who's here.
Hey, who's it?
Hey, Derek. He's here.
It was one time, and I didn't choose to do it, like they made me do it.
Come on, let's not give Ronnie a hard time. It's a family reunion.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Bring that poop in, come on.
Bring that poop in, come on.
You're the worst brother, but...
Come on, man.
Here we are.
Used to eat all of it, like last time.
Yeah, you need that ice cream for 3 hours.
Yes, yeah. Daddy loves that ice cream. I haven't even seen him eat regular food this whole time.
That right leg is, that fake leg is doing pretty well.
Yeah. After they took it away, he took to that peg leg like a duck to water.
Your diabetes sucks.
Yeah. Diabetes does suck.
Although that left leg isn't doing that well.
You know, I think it's just making it. I think he wants to be double peg leg. He's got this whole pirate thing he's been working on, and he wants to be like, he wants us to all call him Peggy.
Have you noticed that Mom just keeps adding sugar to like everything that he's eating? Trying to kill him?
Hey, Penny, what you doing?
Just getting a start on these dishes.
That a boy.
I think Mom likes the pirate thing. Like in a weird way.
Say my best, dude.
I remember that sparkling rug from what part of the Caribbean.
Yeah.
Thick
and thin.
Stormy weather.
And now
now she's my parents' ass. We've got a bright future ahead of us. I feel it in me tempers.
They shiver.
I got chills.
They're
multiplying. I'm mixing the references here.
A little bit, it's okay.
But, you know, I was once a normal lad like all the others, but it's a boring life, ain't it? Bills, deadlines, schedules, boring non-parent women.
What?
But when you choose to make something of yourself, something special, the world, it comes to meet you.
It's your oyster.
You understand me, darling.
Wow, the seizure is beautiful.
What?
Thanks for inviting me on this carnival cruise. I've never been on one before.
We're happy to hear your first experience on the sea.
The high seas.
That's right.
Hopefully we don't get Titanic.
Darling, will you go hit the mast sails?
I know exactly what that means. Yes.
Look, you want to live life, don't you?
Yeah, that's why I don't want to get Titanic.
You want to taste the marrow of very existence, don't you?
Well, yeah. But I don't want to hit an iceberg.
Live on the edge a little. Why don't you climb over the rail? I'll hold you.
This is like immersion therapy. So,
I'm helping you confront your fears. Yeah, yes. I got you. Oh, you're halfway there. Almost there. Yes. No!
Never let go.
You feel that? It's the ocean entering your spirit. Wow. Yes.
I don't have that song.
Hey, what's that over there?
It's an iceberg!
I didn't expect to see that out here.
No!
Maybe I should go to the captain's quarters.
Oh, wait, don't leave me here!
Should I deal with that?
Just deal with that. I didn't want to get Titanic. That's my one wish. The thing that you very last want in life. Maybe that's God. Maybe it's a park. She just threw a tuna sandwich into the sea. Now that's freedom.
Okay.
The funny fucker did it.
Oh. eyes on it and can't keep his teeth on it.
Oh.
What? What?
He's going to therapy for it.
Yeah.
Right, Roger?
Yeah.
Okay, Rod.
Yeah, also means right.
Yeah.
It's us kids.
You kids, you crazy kids. Fuck you, Rod.
Fuck your teacher.
Oh. I'm an instructor. Two different words. Two different meanings, if you will.
Instructor.
Do you know what that means, Roger?
No. But I don't know what that means, yeah, right? Didn't we just say what? No, one confused. What's our lingo now?
One is right.
You're sorry. Why are you sorry? You didn't say anything. Huh?
Yeah, why are you
sorry? Why are you
sorry? You're sorry, Gary. You want to answer something?
Speak up, Gary.
Mr.
Just Johannesburg.
It's instructor!
Oh! Instructor.
Instructor!
There it is!
Johannesburg,
there
sir.
It is.
Please forgive me for eating the homework.
You ate it? That's gross.
I didn't know where else to hide the evidence.
Of
the homework.
Of course. That's okay, Ken. A little baby boy. So next time, Ken.
Yes.
I've always been bad at lying. I was always the one that, whenever there was something that I was supposed to keep up with a group of friends, I cracked under pressure. My mom would just look at me and I would just start to get crumbled. My little brother, he's always getting upset at me about that. I don't know what it was. It was always just like a real stressful type of thing to me with my mom. And I keep going back to my mom because she's always the one that can get me to crack. So, regardless of what I had done, whether it was not doing a homework assignment, whether I had got caught drinking, anything like that, I cracked under pressure. I couldn't deal with it. I'd rather get the truth out, get my punishment over with than.
Jonathan, my son,
have a
seat. You know, it was a pretty beautiful night last night. All the stars were on that cloud in the sky.
It was real nice.
Yeah. I was, I came to sleep last night. Something came over me, and so I had my, just go for a little stroll throughout the house, and I noticed my car was gone.
Oh, crime in the area has been horrible.
Yes, you're right. They must have stolen my car and then brought it back. And filled it with gas to where it was exactly once.
That's nice of the thief.
Yeah. I should have an empty car. Shouldn't I?
These are good cookies.
Yeah.
Hey, honey, I'm running a little late to work. Do you have any bagels or anything fast?
Oh, of course. Yes. I think I kept some in the fridge, so they wouldn't go bad. Here you go.
Love you.
Guess what? Sorry.
Sorry for what?
I'm sorry that somebody stole your car.
Oh, you rat. Rat stallion.
I really wanted to go.
How were they?
Oh man, I bet that thief went. I bet he could really tell you.
if you had a guess, maybe what he would say. How was the accident?
I bet he would say it was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, I bet he would say, like, you couldn't even hear yourself talk. Like, I bet he would say,
the concert was awesome.
I bet he said. I bet he said it was awesome.
Yeah, wait a minute. What the hell?
Crying in terror.
All right, everybody.
Thank you so much for supporting our very first show of our inaugural semester. We are looking forward to doing many more shows next semester. We hope you'll support us by telling people about our shows or coming out to see our shows or joining our theater club. So if you want to talk to us, we'll be out in the lobby.